The character of Geralt is iconic. Can you talk about what it is about the character that you think makes him such a unique sort of leading man, and what made Henry the absolutely perfect fit for that role?
I think it's that, you know, I mean, I think it goes back to sort of those like old like folklore characters that we've sort of grown up with, you know, the sort of doomed demon who, because he's constantly trying to make the world better, is constantly on his own, and therefore, you know, our heart bleeds for him as much as he bleeds for us. And I think that's what makes this role so incredible. It taps into that sort of that trope, if you will, and I think that's something that we recognise because we have all grown up with. All parts of the world have a similar folklore character that they've grown up with, and I think this really taps into that, and universally so. And I think Henry, what he's done is he's brought it to life in a new way, and managed to do it so beautifully, and it's captured the imagination of old fans and new fans, and I think that's what's really important. These are great stories. They take you all over, upside down and all around, and there's so much to get from them and to be excited by from them, and it's just wonderful that Henry's been able to helm this new revival of it. It's such a huge journey that everyone goes on. I can't sum it up for you. I wish I could, but I think that's kind of what's wonderful about The Witcher world, is that you have to watch it and immerse yourself in it, because it's so complex and it spans and reaches so far across these kingdoms. But I, in terms of Tisea, she still very much is concerned with Yennefer, obviously, her sort of adopted daughter, if you will, and then all the other girls at Aretuza who matter so very much to her. But also her need and her desire to create peace within the between all the kingdoms, and how to sort of play that and how to remain at the centre of ensuring that happens. That really is her big driving force.
In season one, the dynamic between you and Anya was sensational and evolved a lot throughout the course of the series. How much screen time do we get to see with you guys back together, and what sort of direction does that take us in season two?
I mean, you never see enough of us together, really. That's the truth. Sad. Really, it should just all be about us. No, it shouldn't. I'm joking. You do. I get my time with Anya, which is wonderful. One, because she's so much fun to work with, and also because I love the relationship, like you said, between Tisea and Yennefer. I think it's really, really special, and it's a huge part of why I love this show so very much. Yes, you will see us. You will see other relationships as well. Other relationships developing with other of the Aretuza girls. It's a lot. I hope you love it, but we've loved making it, and hopefully you'll love watching it.
What's especially wonderful about the show is how much of what we see on screen is actually real. Can you talk a little bit about some of the exciting new locations, the new physical worlds that we get to explore this time?
What can I tell you? I don't know. Well, do you know what? No, I can tell you about my world, though, because my world is, I am very much, MyAnna, no, I'm confusing them now. Tisea's still very much in Aretuza a lot, but Aretuza, for me anyway, has become grander and huger during this season, and that's been really exciting, you know, walking across these, like, hallways that have been built, that I realise are like these caverns of Aretuza that we didn't see in season one. So that's been magic, and I have to say, like, huge hats off to the set department. I mean, the art department have created something remarkable. These are hugely talented artists who are working within our industry, and we get to work on their sets, and audiences are now going to be able to enjoy their sets.